I will actively dedicate myself to feeling better today. I will repay this gift of life with hard work and renewed commitment. Try these for yourself and feel the power of Maria's healing words firsthand.
Yo, Orville's insane. Woo, hey, contamination lasers. Those are new. Where'd I go? Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Hey everybody, it's Cyber Gwar. What's going on? How are my favorite people doing? I am at Lorville, if you couldn't tell. It's Maria Pure of Heart. I think that's Maria Hurston. There used to be people up here. I wonder if they're still up there. Yep. Look at that. There's people walking up there. NPCs. I wonder if they'll ever open that area up for players. Probably nothing much up there. Look at that. They're fading out of existence. Those are all the ghosts of the Hurston workers that were tortured and maimed and forced to work to their deaths. Work off their debt. Maria Pure of Heart Hospital is a non-profit medical facility dedicated to the improving of health of all members of the extended Hurston dynamic family of employees and the community of Lorville through being a leader in delivering excellent healthcare services, expanding medical knowledge, and conducting clinical trials. Focusing on fast, efficient recovery of our patients and devotion to care that is simple and affordable. My lord. Hey! Oh, back at... How did I go? I'm just getting out of here. But this goes to Leavesden. I can get out of here. I know where I'm at. Metro Center. Where I want to go. Sometimes I get lost in Lorville. I don't come here too much. I used to live here for years, and I just kind of forgot where everything laid out. So today, I want to do some exploring. I want to go out to Ariel and look for this old wreck that's out there. There's talk of this Drake Cutlass that went down. So, we're gonna go check it out. It's near Bezdek. Well, using Bezdek as the anchor point, you can find it. So you head over to Bezdek and then you go on heading 95 for 223.5 kilometers. And you should come across a wreck out there for a Cutty Black. Let's go take a look at it. And we can't find it. I know of another place I want to go over here on Hurston. That my buddy Junior found yesterday. He's one of my org mates, and he is an explorer through and through, and one hell of a man. And we're gonna go over there and check it out. We were there yesterday. We found this cool lake and river in the, or he found it, and I went and looked at it. This cool lake and river, like a Rocky Canyon river inside the acid field. Oh man, it was beautiful. I got there near sunset though, so I didn't have much time to explore or really record much of it. But we're gonna get out there and look. And I'm not sure what time. I gotta remember where it's at. I gotta find it. I have it on video when I went there, so I'm gonna have to look at the video before I go out there. So. To figure out exactly where it was, but coming in from orbit, I was able to see the river, so that will help a lot. I don't know where my normal helmet is. I had a helmet on. I actually logged off of my ship last night, and I woke up here, so something happened. I think my helmet is on my ship. At least I hope it is, and I didn't lose it. Because it's basically this helmet. Oop, get up. Get up! Basically the Neone helmet, but it's red. It matches this helmet. But I found a green one when I was at a caterpillar wreck yesterday, so I actually had that in my backpack still.
Welcome to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
So I just put it on. Oh no. My nomad's at Stanton? Oh no! If I claim it, I'm gonna lose everything there. It got stored in the center of the verse. Huh. What do I do? If I claim it, I lose all my stuff in it. Wasn't much in there? Or was there? I don't remember. You know what? I'm gonna lose this helmet. Or the red helmet, if it's in there. Let's just claim it. Screw it.
To the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
The Carrick is deliverable. Oh man, my Nomad had my mule in it and I wanted my mule. It's fine, I'll grab it.
Your insurance claim has been sent.
I hope I don't lose the mule for claiming this. All right. Sometimes that happens. I lost my Ursa Rover when I claimed a ship and it was in the hold and I wasn't ever able to recall it. All right, we got a minute. But, yeah, I want to thank you guys for hanging out here, man. Viewership is growing. Subscribers are growing. It's amazing. I can't believe it. You guys are doing wonderful things, man. Guys, I hope you're as interested in this game as I am. People have accused me of being a white knight for Star Citizen, and it... You know, if you want to say that, go right ahead. Your opinion of me does not matter to me. So, that's none of my business what you think, but... I love this game, and I'm not going to deny it. I'm always going to champion it. I'm going to criticize it when it's bad, and I'm going to love it when it's great. And honestly, this game's great, because I know what the big picture of this game is, man. I know what they're trying to accomplish, and trust me, what you see so far is nothing of what they're... going to accomplish with this game. A lot of people think it's a scam or whatever, and they're just so misguided and uninformed. I don't know why I did that. So, been here for 10 years, been here since the Kickstarter. I've never regretted one day of ever helping support this game. And that's what we're doing here in Early Access, man. Everyone here is a supporter, you know? You come in, you can buy this little ship, you know, like for $40 and play the game. Never have to pay a penny ever again. And you get to experience this huge, vast universe. And there's other people who love the game so much that, you know, they'll buy hammerheads and buy those things for real money. And, you know, because that's just funding the development, you know, because we believe in this project. And, we're actually seeing it all come together here. And plus we're help funding Squadron 42, which I think was going to be probably one of the most amazing games ever made. I really hope so. So we're not just building one game, we're building two, and we get to reap the benefits from one to the other. A lot of stuff that's been done for Squadron 42 isn't even over here yet because they want to release that first before they bring that tech into this game. So people who play Squadron 42 will be... have their mind blown. It's basically what they said. Keep it a secret. I'm hoping it'll be out soon. When you look at the tracker on Squadron 42 and the progress they're making... Alright, it's here. You can really see they're in the late stage development of that game, so... I'm hoping we have some kind of cool announcement at CitizenCon. They seem to have changed the format and the way they present information. It's just all these little clues stating that they're really far along in development. And, I have a feeling there's a big, huge announcement coming at CitizenCon. That's just my feeling. I don't have any proof. You know, I don't have any special way of knowing what CIG's doing, but I get the same information you all get, but I'm not the only one speculating here about what's happening with Squadron 42. All right, let's get to the action, man. Yeah, I appreciate you guys so much. You guys been using my Amazon affiliate links. You've been checking out other creators I promote here, like Clover TV and Clip of the Day, Star Citizen. You guys are awesome. I haven't had any trolls on the channel lately, which is good. People who just somehow lack social interaction abilities to not be absolute freaking tools, you know? So maybe the audience is growing, or maybe I just bored them to death and they were like, oh, it's not even worth the effort. This guy's boring. Which is probably true. Oh, look at this. The new Lorville is freaking cool. Man. They do one such a wonderful job. I can't wait to see Terra. Like, just the concept art and everything I've seen of Terra and the 3D models that they've worked on. And people have been able to pull out of files and things and a few leaks. Terra is going to be amazing. I hear you're actually going to be able to drive cars around in Terra too. Which will be awesome. You won't have to rely on public transport. See you later, Lorville. We basically want to head due east. We want to go on a heading of 95 degrees once we get the best at. Actually, I'm going to stop at Bezdek first to pick up my mule. So we want to go on heading 95. That's pity. Alright, heading 95. In here. There we go. 95. All right. It looks like we're sort of heading back towards Hurston. Keep it locked here. Alright, 100 more kilometers to go. Ariel is by far my favorite moon. It's just so hostile and so alien feeling here. Hey, we made it to the Cheese Highlands. My god. I think I found it. Is that a rock or is that a cutlass? Landing gear engaged. That is Drake Cutlass. It's the Frosty Nuff. Wow. I wonder if there's anything here. I have no idea if NPCs are here or not, but...
Wow.
Look at this place. I don't know why they don't use these old racks and missions still. They're still out here. They still exist. I mean, they just throw a box or something or a dead body here and there. They're still super interesting. Take anybody's hair, the weapon away. Ah, there's one of the wings that always falls off Drake. Yeah, okay. So this cutlass is called the Frosty Knuth or Knuth. I'm not really sure how you say that word, Knuth. K-N-U-T-H.
Wow.
And so I got here by going... I basically triangulated 220 kilometers from Bezdek on heading 95, and then I... Set my other marker like 363 from OM1. So head out like 220 kilometers on heading 95 from Bezdek, and then get about 360, 362 kilometers from OM1. You should be all right. Can't get up there. Oh, there we go. And you'll find this place. It's the only thing out here, it looks like a cutlass. So once I found it, it was easy to see against the... Man, look, is that like HIDA? HDR? It's like a simulated HDR. I can't wait till they have real HDR in this game. Which I know they're working on right now. I think, in fact, they've got it basically... installed in an upcoming update. HDR, DLSS, Vulkan, all that good stuff's coming. A lot of optimizations to the graphics engine now that they got Gen 12 renderer in. Now I got like a 19 minute survival rating. So if you do come here, make sure you got some really hot temperature gear. I don't have that, unfortunately, but I have my ship I can go back into. Everything's just laid about. It's a shame they don't use these locations, man. They used to use these locations for years. And I don't know, maybe they do still use them. I just never get a mission out here. Then again, I don't come out to Hurston and work much anyway. But Hurston has a lot of stuff. My guy's overheating. You can hear him breathing. His temperature's rising. 36.6 degrees Celsius. The 133 degrees Celsius here. All right, I found it. My navigational skills aren't total shit. All right, I wonder if they have the name on the side of the thing. I doubt it. I don't even know where they would put the name on the side of a cutlass. They don't have it in game yet. It used to be a mission area. You'd have to come out here and get boxes. Is that the door I'm standing on? Yes, it is. There's another wreck out here somewhere. Just not sure how to get to it from here. I had to go back to where I was yesterday, look at the video, and figure out how I got there. Because I jumped onto them, I didn't jump onto any points, but it's in between Barnabas and whatever that other one was. Oh, it's nighttime here too. Crap, it's going to suck. That's going to make it next to impossible to find. It's gonna be 45 minutes until it's daylight here. Oh crap. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna sit up in orbit. Go up to OM6. And I'm gonna camp out there until it's daylight. All right, well, since it's nighttime on this side of Hurston, and the planet orbits pretty quickly, but I gotta wait about 45 minutes for the sun to come up, I'm just gonna end this as part one, and then part two will pick up tomorrow as we make our way down to the Hurston's acidic fields to find Junior's gorge that he brought us and showed us the Rocky River Canyon that was down there in the acid fields. So that'll be part two. That'll come tomorrow, I promise you. Thanks so much for watching, hanging out, showing the channel a bunch of support. It's been wonderful, guys. I'll see you tomorrow. Tune on back in. Love you guys.